Krishna. I am handling electronic circuit analysis for second year, second semester. It is a core subject for electronics communication engineering students. Today I am going to explain the concept of feedback amplifier. It is a block diagram of feedback. This is a concept of feedback system. This is a block diagram of feedback system. So here input signal is 5S. Input signal applied to feedback amplifier is 5S, and the output of mixer. The block diagram of your feedback amplifier consists basically these four blocks. First one is mixer, and second one is basic amplifier with gain A, and sampler, and it's followed by feedback network beta. So here the feedback signal, feedback output is generated by 5F, and the input to your feedback network is generated by here 5-0, and output of your mixer, is generated by 5A. So that is the output input signals to mixer are, one is 5S, another one 5F. So here 5S plus or minus 5F. Two signals input to your mixer, one is source signal 5S, another one is feedback signal 5F, and these 5I is input to your feedback amplifier with gain. It is a open loop amplifier, which is basic amplifier used. And output of your basic amplifier is denoted by 5-0. This 5-0 is input to your sampler, and the sampler samples this output signal. This is voltage signal. 5-0 is voltage signal that is input to your sampler, and sampler output is denoted by here 5-0. Output of this one sampler is 5-0. So that 5-0 is again sent back to your feedback network, and that is converted into 5F. So your main concept is why we are using feedback. What is feedback amplifier? So your amplifier is electronic circuit which increases applied input signal, which increases magnitude of applied input signal. For example, this is amplifier. Amplifier is an electronic circuit which increases applied input signal. So gain is generated by A, otherwise AV. The input to this is your VI. Input voltage applied to amplifier is VI, and output again is your V0, and your AV is equal to V0 by VI. Okay, this is voltage gain. This is denoted by voltage gain of open loop amplifier. So your applied input signal is sinusoidal signal to this one, that is denoted by VI, positive amplitude, reference, and negative amplitude. Okay, this is in the range of millivolts. Applied input signal to amplifier is very, very small, and which increases magnitude level. And here we'll get an inverted output signal. Common emitter amplifier is 180 degrees phase shift. So here V0 is the negative amplitude, reference, and your positive amplitude with respect to time. So here we'll get in the range of volts. Output signal we'll get in the range of volts. Here this is an amplifier. In this electronic circuit analysis, throughout this ECA subject, we'll analyze different types of amplifiers, like multi-stage amplifiers, and feedback amplifiers, power amplifiers, tuned amplifiers, so like that. So we have feedback amplifier. Now what do you mean by feedback amplifier? So feedback generally used in amplifier for getting more bandwidth. We use feedback in amplifier, there are so many advantages. That's why you use feedback in amplifier. Now what is feedback? Feedback means, so amplifier amplifies signal. Main purpose of amplifier is amplification. Okay? So whatever amplified signal, if it is not desired one, it is sampled again. This is sampled with the help of sampler, that whatever portion, desired portion, a portion of desired undesired signal is sent back to input to your mixer when amplifier with the help of feedback network. The feedback network ratio is given by beta. The portion whichever undesired output signal is again sent to your input with the help of feedback network for further amplification. That is what your feedback system means. So mainly your feedback. Example for this feedback amplifier, this is using large signal amplifier. You should get large signal across output. In order to get large signal, the output signal is amplified number of times and is sent back to your input with the power mixer. The mixer mixes signal. It mixes signal and subtracts. That is the plus means for your positive feedback. Your negative means your negative feedback. So your feedbacks we have two types. One is positive feedback. Positive feedback network. Second one is your negative feedback system. Negative feedback. So here 5S and 5F are two input signals to your mixer. It is coming from your 5S and 5F. If 5S and 5F are both in phase, your source signal and feedback signal both are in phase, then the network used is called positive feedback. If 5S and 5F are out of phase, then feedback used is a negative feedback. Right? Okay, that's your 5F is input your amplifier. Is a basic amplifier. So now here A is the output by input gain, voltage gain. Phi naught by your phi n. The voltage gain of basic amplifier A is equal to phi naught by phi n. So next coming to feedback network. Feedback network beta it is. That is denoted by beta. Output is here phi f. Output is phi f and input is here phi naught. So output phi f divided by input phi naught, voltage signal. So now next coming to the overall gain of your feedback network, that is denoted by your AF. AF is equal to your output is here phi naught and input is here phi s. So total output is your phi naught of feedback amplifier and input to your feedback amplifier is phi s. So now these are the three factors very important we will analyze for feedback amplifier. One is A, that is a phi naught by phi i, output by input, that is output phi naught to input is phi i. Similarly, for a feedback network, output is phi f, input is phi naught. So now, total overall gain of feedback network is denoted by AF. That is a voltage gain with the feedback, is phi naught by phi s. So now, positive feedback and negative feedback, two types of feedbacks are used. In this feedback system. So now positive feedback is used in oscillator. Positive feedback used in oscillator and negative feedback is used in amplifiers. Negative feedback that is used in amplifiers and positive feedback is used in oscillators. So that is how many. So here we will calculate this one, AF. AF voltage gain with feedback we will use. So here phi naught divided by phi s. So based upon this phi s. The phi s here we have equation phi s plus or minus phi a. That is in positive feedback. If we use positive feedback, so that is phi i. Phi i is equal to phi s plus your phi f. Phi a is phi s plus phi. So now this phi s is equal to phi I minus phi f. Phi s is equal to phi I minus phi f. Okay, this phi s will substitute in this one. That is equal to your phi naught divided by your phi I minus your phi f. So this is equal to, so we will take phi naught output signal common in numerator and denominator. So we will get 1 by your phi i by phi naught minus your phi f by your phi naught. So now, okay, this AF, okay, this AF is equal to, this AF is equal to 1 by, okay, this is phi i by phi naught means, where A is what? Phi naught by phi i. So you will write this one, that is 1 by A. So this A. Why? Because here phi i by phi naught is 1 by A we get. Similarly here beta is phi f by phi naught. This phi f by phi naught is here beta. Minus is a beta. This. Okay, this is equal to. So you take LCM here. So 1 by 1 minus A beta by here A. This will write A by 1 minus A beta. 1 by this is equal to A by 1 minus A beta. For example, A beta is equal to 1. If A beta is equal to 1, what happens? A beta is equal to 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So then AF becomes here. A beta is equal to 1. Then AF becomes infinity. AF becomes infinity. So such a feedback network generates AC output signal without giving any AC input signal. Okay, that's why it is a positive feedback. This positive feedback is used in oscillators. So now positive feedback is used in oscillator because at A beta is equal to 1, A beta is equal to 1, with feedback the gain is becoming infinity. In such case, without applying any AC input signal, it uses AC output signal. Similarly, negative feedback. If you use negative feedback, what happens? We will see. Negative feedback. So here AF is phi naught by phi s. Here phi s is for negative feedback, phi i is equal to phi s minus phi i. So this is phi i is equal to phi s here minus phi i. So here phi s is equal to phi i plus phi i. Phi x is equal to phi i plus, so this phi s value will substitute here, phi naught by phi i plus phi i. So here again, here numerator we have phi naught, we will take phi naught common, we get 1 by phi i by phi naught plus phi f by here phi naught. So which we can write this one, 1 by phi i by phi naught. Phi i by phi naught here, 1 by k. Right? That is 1 by A plus beta is what? Beta is equal to phi f by phi naught beta. So this if we substitute here beta. So this becomes this is equal to 1 by we take LCM here A beta by A. This becomes right A by 1 plus A beta. A by 1 plus A beta. So here, if A beta is very much greater than 1, if A beta very much greater than 1, what happens? This AF is equal to A by this A beta. A gets cancelled. So here we get A beta is equal to 1 by beta. A is equal to 1 by beta. Now with gain, feedback with gain is equal to 1 by beta. So now in amplifiers we use negative feedback. So total feedback that AF will depend upon beta factor only. By adjusting this feedback network, by adjusting this feedback network, we can manage AF value. Gain with feedback. So now gain with feedback depends only on beta factor. So if we use this feedback network in amplifier section, here bandwidth increases and this input resistance we can increase and output resistance we can decrease. At the same time noise decreases and distortion decreases. So only you have to make voltage gain stable in this one. So here bandwidth, input resistance R naught, noise and your distortion are very important parameters in feedback system. Thank you.